Oh, in our midday, though, and this afternoon, a really quiet day. So great for the Bengals tailgaters this morning. Should be fine if you're heading out to the game this afternoon. Here's a look at our city cam shot with the high visibility. We do have clear skies this morning. Temperatures dropping back into the 20s, low 30s and upper 20s, similar to the last couple of mornings. That wind chill right now, it feels like the low to mid 20s. A wind chill factored in, it feels like 24. The air temperature at 31, a southwest wind at 7 miles an hour. So pretty average for what we've had the last couple of mornings with the quiet conditions and the high visibility. Satellite and radar showing any cloud cover up across the Great Lakes not impacting us right now. We are keeping it clear. There are some clouds, though, edging into northern parts of Indiana and Ohio, and we will see some clouds return this afternoon. So an increase in afternoon clouds with a cold front arriving. Not a true cold front by definition in terms of our pressure gradient, but it's really the high pressure out across the plains is going to grab a chunk of cold air and send it south across the Great Lakes. It'll drag some clouds our way later this afternoon, switch our winds more out of the northwest, limit our warm up a few degrees. Yesterday we made it to 42. Today we're talking mid to upper 30s. So a little bit of a setback. With that north flow during the overnight tonight and into tomorrow, notice it's grabbing enough moisture off the Great Lakes to drag some lake effect snow showers, especially across portions of northern Indiana and Ohio. But some of them will likely drag in tomorrow morning and midday and early afternoon. You can see that moisture pushing all the way down through Fort Wayne, eastern parts of Indiana, toward the tri-state. So they'll even slide into eastern parts of Kentucky, especially with the uplift of the eastern mountains there in Kentucky. So encouraging some more of them. Some isolated snow showers tomorrow morning and midday. Not all of us seeing activity, but locations that do see a snow burst could see a covering of snow, a reduced visibility at times. Our future cast showing this evening some extra clouds during the overnight, mostly cloudy and pretty quiet. And here comes some of the lines. Now keep in mind, any location in the tri-state will be a possibility tomorrow morning and midday for some of those snow showers to arrive. Not necessarily there on the east side of town in the morning hours. And then we'll quiet down with more sunshine late for our Monday. So it is a pretty limited time frame. But on your way out to work tomorrow morning, I do think you want to be aware they'll be sliding from the north to the south across the region. And isolated snow showers early as 5 a.m. I think we'll see more of them 8, 9, 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. Temperatures will be in the 20s. That quick burst of snow could drop your visibility, a quick covering of snow potential, and we will have the pavement temperatures down below freezing with those air temperatures in the 20s. So we could see a little bit on the pavement, especially those bridges and overpasses. No widespread problems, but something to be aware of. 38 degrees for a high temperature today. We'll increase our clouds during the afternoon and keep them around tonight. We drop off to 24. Tomorrow afternoon, with the snow showers around, we'll only top out at 32. It will be a chilly to cold Monday. By Tuesday, we have more sunshine, but it's still cold at 35. We start to come out of it the rest of the forecast in the 40s, and when moisture returns, it looks like rain Friday and Saturday, but next weekend does look like a cold front that should drop us back by Sunday. Kyla.
Thank you, Jennifer. A late night